The SBA 504 loan has often been in the shadows of the other SBA loan program that a lot of people have heard about, which is called the 7A. It's unfortunate, but frankly, it's part of human nature. And most providers of commercial loans in America, frankly, are banks. Occasionally credit unions, more and more, non-bank lenders, et cetera. But most people want to do what's easiest for them, which is to provide their conventional product. Unfortunately, that doesn't always work for business owners because a conventional commercial loan probably is 70 to 80% loan-to-value financing. That means a lot of down payment from the business owner. It may not be practical. It may not be economical in those cases. So a lot of times if the business owner, argues or not really argues, but brings up that that's a lot of money, they have to liquidate a lot of accounts to come up with that kind of a down payment, they may say, what other low down payment programs do you have? And oftentimes the bank or the credit union will bring up the competing SBA product called the 7A. Now the 7A is a great loan for certain proceeds, working capital, business acquisitions, partner buyouts, debt consolidation, a variety of other uses, okay? But probably not the best loan for commercial real estate, in my opinion. Mostly because most 7A loans are floating rate loans, and commercial real estate fundamentally is a fixed asset. So you have a mismatch in terms of how you're financing that asset. Also, the 7A often requires extra collateral, not just what you're financing. In the case of real estate, you may actually have to pledge a second mortgage on your home. You may have to pledge your inventory and your receivables. There's a lot more that goes into a 7A loan because it's statutorily required to be a fully collateralized loan. So that's why oftentimes 504 never even gets brought up. Now, it does get brought up when the project is bigger than $5 million because, conveniently, the 7A has a cap of $5 million right now. So only in those cases where it's a real estate and or heavy equipment transaction that's more than $5 million will oftentimes a bank or credit union bring up the SBA 504 loan. If it weren't for some of the marketing efforts that I've done for almost 20 years out there in the marketplace and the educational efforts I've done, there wouldn't be as many people that know about the SBA 504 loan as there is. We've made major inroads. We've got a long ways to go. But the bottom line is, I always argue, if you're a bank or credit union, put all three options on the table. Invariably, the business owner is going to choose the SBA 504 loan. And frankly, they may do the 504 loan for the real estate and have a companion 7A loan for the working capital piece. And that makes a lot more sense for most business owners than to do an SBA 7A loan or try and do a much lower term, much higher down payment conventional bank loan.